Hello students, we are discussing about labor cost. In relation to labor cost, there is another one important topic is labor turnover, which has direct impact on the labor cost. Increased in labor turnover would increase the labor cost. So we have to know what is the labor turnover. Labor turnover is the percentage of changes in the labor force. As we know that labor force is not remain same in an organization, so there is changes in the labor force. Some new person may come to the organization, they can join the organization, or some person may left out the organization, there may be new hiring, then etc. So these may change the total structure of the labor composition. So that is it analyzed that changes is known as labor turnover. So labor turnover is the percentage of changes in the labor force due to new entry or due to the left out of the old employees. So there may be different region of labor turnover. Labor turnover, so when there is an increase in the number of labor turnover, when it does not mean that the company is having good picture, so we can say the company it is unfavorable. The high labor turnover is unfavorable for the company. So next we have to know the types of labor turnover. Type of labor turnover means what are included in labor turnover. First one we can say it is the accession. Accession means it means selections or addition of new employees, that is entry of new employees or selection of new employees is known as accession. Then separation, when person left out the organization, when the person leave the organization is known as separation. So there these two situations comes under labor turnover. Next we have to know the causes of labor turnover, the why people leave the organization. So what there might be different reasons. Some are avoidable causes and some are unavoidable causes. Avoidable causes are those causes that with some effort of from the side of the management, they can avoid the turnover by changes in the strategies, by changes in the personnel plannings and policies, by taking some corrective actions, by taking some remedial measures, the organization can stop the turnover. So that type of causes comes under avoidable causes, if the person is dissatisfied with the salary, working conditions, medical benefits and other incentives and other promotional benefits, etc. So in that case, these are the avoidable causes which can be controlled by the management with their effort. Then again, there are some unavoidable causes which the company cannot control, no one can control, the person is absent for a long period of time, then if the misconduct of the person, then retrenchment due to the lack of work, etc. So these are the reasons are unavoidable which the company cannot avoid, even the person cannot avoid. Then there are some very personal reasons for which the company, the person may leave a organization, this may be the domestic region, then for women employees there are some other problems like that. So these are the very personal. Then the person become unable to work due to he is unfit to work, etc. So these are the personal reasons for which the person may leave the organization. But the company should try to avoid labor turnover as far as possible. For that, they should take some remedies having proper strategies, proper recognitions, proper working conditions, scientific selection of the employees, scientific training of the employees. So these steps can avoid huge amount of labor turnover. Then every organization wants to calculate the labor turnover. For that, they use some formula, and out of this formula, some important formula, one is a separate rate method, where number of workers separated in a particular period is divided by the average number of employees during the period. Then another method, it is a replacement method, that is how many person is replaced in an organization is divided by the average number of persons during that period into 100, And another one is known as flux method, where number of workers separated plus number of workers replaced divided by average number of persons during the period into 100. Then in that way the percentage of labor turnover is calculated. In average number of persons during particular period is calculated by the opening number of persons plus the closing number of employees divided by 2. So it is calculated like this. So by calculating this, average number of persons during period is identified, calculated. So we can say labor turnover is a percentage of changes in the workforce of an organization.